Todoist have done it again. Another update, another new feature. Well, not such a great feature, but something that was disappeared when we had the upcoming update, and now it's come back again, but it's come back even better than before. What am I talking about? I'm talking about the home button. What we used to do was we used to click on the Todoist icon in the top left-hand side of the window, and that would take us back to our home screen. Now, a lot of people never actually set up the home screen. They didn't realize that it was customizable, but it is customizable, and that's what I'm going to show you today. I'm going to show you how to customize your home button, and I'm actually going to show you just some of the new additional keyboard shortcuts that Todoist have launched, because these save you a ton of time. Now, before we go into my Todoist, I'd just like to ask you, if you do get any value from this episode, then please help me by hitting that like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel and you do want to get all the latest tips, tricks, and news on using Todoist, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, it's now time for me to take you into my Todoist and show you all the new features that have come out in the last week or so. Okay, first up, the changes. What's happened now is, for those of you who are observant, will have noticed up here in the top left-hand corner, we now have this home symbol, and this actually does take you to the home. Now, your home setup is default at today's view, so you'll see today's view. If you have anything overdue, by the way, that will also show up in here, but this is essentially what you get as your default view. So if I just go into my inbox here, I have a sample task set up. What I'm going to do is I'm going to change this, and I'm just going to add the date as of yesterday, so we'll just make that the 16th of May 2020. That's now going to make that an overdue task, as you can see. So when I go into my today's view now, it's showing as an overdue task. Now, this is the default setup. Now, if you want to change your home button, what this home button will do, as I have done here, I have a customized home or start page. Now, one thing I should point out, because I really want to explain about the keyboard shortcuts, because these do save you a lot of time. As you can see, this now means all I have to do is hit H. So if I hit the H button, that's going to take me to my home, or my home view, which is, I like to see my inbox at the top, and then overdue and today. Now, for some of you, if you have a lot of follow-ups to do and you may label things as a follow-up, then you may want to add follow-ups underneath or wherever. Now, to start off with, if you want to change your home button, what you need to do is go to your filters. So this is where the best place to do it. I mean, you can create a project as a home button. You can create a label if you wish. I actually have one set up here. It's my home button. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into here and I'm going to show you what I've done. So essentially the home button for me is, I mean, I call this, actually in the past I've called this my dashboard, which I prefer. So I'm going to call that dashboard. Oops. And what we can do is, mine is P:inbox. Now, the P: is the project indicator. So you could create P:this week or P:next week, whatever you want to use. And then I've got my overdue and then my today, and I put commas between them. And what this does is this shows the order in which these are going to come up. So I'm going to see my inbox at the top, then my overdue tasks, and then today. And I color that red, you can color that whatever you want. You can, of course, you can add that to your favorites as well. If you click that, that will add it to your favorites. So you also have another way of getting to it quickly. So once you've set up the filter that you want to show as your home button, to change your home button, what you do is you go to the settings here, go into your settings, and you go to general. And from general, you'll see here the start page. So I call it the home button, but actually you can call it, it's called the start page. And as you can see here, mine is set up as dashboard. If you click the drop down menu, you can go from filters, you can go to your, I don't have any labels, but if you go to, you can go to your projects, and you've got these queries here, today and upcoming, which are the standard ones if you wish. So you can do whatever you want. I could make this my this week folder, or as in my case, I prefer the dashboard. So what you do is you go to the start page, use the drop down menu, and that will set you up with your start page. So close out of that. And essentially, that's all you have to do to create the start page. So this means that whenever you start Todoist, it will always open up at this page. Now, if I go into my upcoming view and I do my weekly planning session, I'm using these, I'm just going through them. So I'm going to go into next week and I can do this. So you can change whatever you want. I'm going to go back, obviously, to today. And what I can do is now if I think, right, okay, I've seen that. If I hit my H button, it's going to take me back to my home button where I want the home. So as we go along the top now, so these new features, what Todoist appears to be doing is adding more and more keyboard shortcuts, which is great because keyboard shortcuts really do speed up your the way that you use Todoist. And one of the things I really wanted to point out while we're doing this is if you go into Todoist preferences, you don't get many preferences, but what you've got is general, which doesn't really change very much. But the one I'm more interested in is the keyboard shortcuts. So you've got a show or hide Todoist, which in this case is Shift T for me, and that will just show and hide it. It doesn't really do very much. So if I hit T, Shift T, it will disappear. It's Control T on the Mac. And if I hit Control T again, it will come back. So there's one way of doing it. I don't use that particularly very much, but the one I use all the time is my quick add task. And now I've got this set up as Shift Command A. You can change this, you can create it once. But the way I think of this is Shift Command A for add. So I'm adding a task. So this means that if I am in, let's say I'm going to go into Safari. So I will just open up Safari. And if I open up Safari, what you'll see is in here, I'll just get that resized for us. So what I can do here is if I go to Todoist, so Todoist keyboard shortcuts, and I'm going to put a link to this page actually in the show notes so you can actually see them. So from here you've got all sorts of, and you can actually go and switch your platform, you've got web, all these various ones here, and you can go here. So there's a lot of tasks. So here's the standard seems to be set up Control Command T and Control Command A. You can change these obviously, and you've got all these various ones here, and just choose the platform that you want. I will put a link to this page in the actual show notes, but what I wanted to show you is now if I'm in this and I think, oh yeah, this is a really good idea, I can hit Shift Command A and it will bring up my add task. So even though I'm actually in Safari, as you can see here, this is like a global shortcut, and I use this all the time to quickly capture my task. So it's a really, really useful feature to have. And so essentially you want to be setting that up for that. Of course, you've got the close menu and open menu. So if you just hit the M key, you can close the menu. If you hit the M key again, it will bring the menu back. If you hit F for find, because it's over here, you can just go straight into your quick find. So you can find stuff in there and you can go looking. I've got an F, so. And as I've mentioned many times before, Todoist search is fantastic. And then over here, you've got your various ones and there's no keyboard shortcuts there. But that's essentially what I wanted to show you this week. This is a new feature that came out maybe in the last few days, in the last week or two, 10 days or so. And it's really useful to get used to using the keyboard shortcuts because they really do speed up the way that you use Todoist on a day-to-day basis. Well, thank you very much for watching this episode. It just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Well, thank you very much for watching this video. Now, I'd like to introduce you to a brand new way of managing your tasks. Now, this system is called the Time Sector System. It's designed to do away with your projects, to do away with your goals, or at least do away with them from your time management system, your to-do list manager, and instead focuses on when you are going to do the task. Now, the reason for this is from a research that I did for the whole of last year, figuring out why most people were really struggling with their tasks, getting their tasks done on a day-to-day basis. What I discovered was they were managing their tasks by project. And the biggest problem with managing tasks by project is, first of all, deciding whether a task is a project or not. Two or more tasks becomes a project, which means that you end up with a huge project list. And once you have a huge project list, just managing that list takes up an awesome amount of time. time you could well better be spent actually doing the work, not organizing. The time sector method is designed to do away with all that processing so that the only decision you have to make is when are you going to do a task. And let's be honest, it doesn't matter how motivated, inspired, how urgent a task is. If you don't have time to do it, it is never going to get done. So the whole clip, this, I have launched a brand new course that gives you the step-by-step approach of setting up the time sector method. It's a revolutionary course. It's designed for the 21st century. For all the inputs that we get today, all the emails, the Slack messages, and everything else that comes our way, it's designed to deal with that, to manage that, so you stay focused on what you have identified are your most important tasks for the day. I'd love to see you in the course. Full details of the course are in the show notes below. I'd love you to check it out. Join me in the course and let's take your productivity to a greater level than you've ever, ever imagined. Well, thank you very much for watching this video. I just wish you all a very, very productive week.